This painting is a 16th century piece by Paolo Veronese titled Feast in the House of Levi. This particular painting is actually quite large, measuring 18 feet and 2 inches by 42 feet, and it's done in the popular Venetian Renaissance medium of oil on canvas. It can currently be found in the Galleria dell'Accademia in Venice. The painter of Feast in the House of Levi, Veronese, was a master Venetian painter during the 16th century and completed this particular work in 1573. His paintings, such as this one, were typically done in the late Renaissance style of Mannerism, which was actually the dominant style in Venice at the time. The style of Mannerism tends to be more artificial and less naturalistic than earlier Renaissance styles, usually having very vivid colors and exaggerated emotions and movements. Veronese's unique style can be characterized by the use of a very wide range of colors and surface textures, and the fact that his figures are neither particularly static nor dramatic, but actually seem to move in quite a stately rhythm. He really enjoyed painting figures and usually includes an abundance of figures dressed in very sumptuous costumes. The biblical scene depicted in this painting lends to it its namesake as the Feast in the House of Levi. In this biblical story, Levi invites Jesus to a banquet and makes him a grand feast in his own house. Christ can be seen at the center of the painting, which is very typical, but the unusual aspect is that the scene depicting Christ is actually so small and almost lost within the rest of the painting. Among Christ and his apostles, there are several other figures. Many of these figures are dressed in foreign, very exotic clothing, which actually serves to emphasize Venice as a multicultural city, as well as its important role in trade. The overall aura of wealth and prosperity in Venice is also emphasized, which really adds to that myth of Venice. All of these figures seem to distract from the central Last Supper scene, as that scene is a relatively small part of the painting as a whole. The contrast between that quiet drama at the center of the composition with the busy feasting at the sides is emphasized by the strongly centralized design, which seems to resemble that of a triptych in composition. The architecture depicted in the scene also serves to emphasize this triptych-like central composition with the three large arches that seem to split the painting into thirds. Additionally, the use of Corinthian columns and arches also harkens back to the classical style of architects such as Palladio. Feast in the House of Levi was actually not this painting's original title. It had initially been commissioned by the refectory at S.S. Giovanni e Paolo as a Last Supper painting. It was specifically meant to replace the previous painting, Last Supper by Titian, after it was destroyed by a fire in 1571. When Veronese first brought the painting to the monastery, the monks thought the feast looked more like a party than a Last Supper. The monks actually ended up rejecting the painting and told Veronese to go fix it. Specifically, the inclusion of so many figures, the inclusions of buffoons, drunkards, Germans, dwarves, and similar vulgarities, in a religious scene as important as the Last Supper was not received well, especially by the Inquisition. Veronese was actually put on trial by the inquisitors, as they thought he should be charged with heresy for the painting. As part of the Counter-Reformation, the Catholic Church believed the artist had too much freedom and were not really following the biblical text exactly. To appease inquisitors and monks, Veronese decided to simply change the title of the painting from the Last Supper to a less sensitive and lesser-known biblical scene, Feast in the House of Levi. After changing the title, the painting was accepted. Veronese must have learned from this experience because he never again painted a religious painting in this way, but rather took a more spiritually committed approach. Despite the initial reaction to this painting, it has become one of Veronese's most well-known and beloved paintings today.